Assalamu alaikum and good evening. You are watching Hamsab TV and I am Muneeb Hamid with the news. Cabinet approves signing of MOUs with several countries. The federal cabinet has accorded approval to signing of a number of memoranda of understanding submitted by different ministries. The cabinet, which met in Islamabad under the chair of Prime Minister Shahid Khaqan Abbasi, also accorded approval for signing the memorandum of understanding on bilateral political consultations between the ministries of foreign affairs of Denmark and Pakistan. The cabinet approved signing the MOU on bilateral consultation between the ministries of foreign affairs of Pakistan and the Slovak Republic. Approvals were accorded for memorandums of understanding between the United Nations Economic and Social Commission for Asia and the Pacific and the National School of Public Policy, and between Sri Lanka Institute of Development Administration and the National School of Public Policy of Pakistan. Formal launch of Saudi-led coalition on Sunday. The Saudi-led coalition against terrorism is formally being launched with a meeting of the defense ministers of member states being held in Riyadh on Sunday. The inaugural meeting of the Islamic Military Counter-Terrorism Coalition, IMCTC, Ministers of Defense Council will be held under the theme of Allied Against Terrorism. According to a press statement, IMCTC Acting Secretary General Lieutenant General Abdullah Al Saleh said, "This meeting marks the official launch of the IMCTC's operations at our center in Riyadh." The alliance, described as a 41-nation pan-Islamic coalition, was announced in December 2015. Pakistan was part of the initial list of 34 countries that had agreed to become part of the coalition. Pakistan's former Army Chief General Raheel Sharif joined the alliance as its top commander in April this year. IATC issues contempt of court notice to Ehsan Iqbal for inaction over Faizabad sit-in. The Islamabad High Court has issued a show cause notice for contempt of court to Interior Minister Ehsan Iqbal over his failure to take steps ordered by the court to end the sit-in that has brought the capital to halt for the past 17 days. The court has inquired in the notice under which authority did the minister not take action against sit-in despite orders of the High Court. The court issued the notice while hearing two applications filed by residents about disturbance caused by the protracted sit-in. The Interior Secretary represented the Interior Ministry before the court, which ordered the Interior Minister to appear in person on November 27. AIG martyred in suicide blast targeting Peshawar police. Additional Inspector General AIG Headquarters Ashraf Noor was martyred in a suspected suicide blast targeting a police vehicle in Peshawar's Hayatabad area on Friday. The blast appeared to be a suicide attack. Supreme Court issues notice to Interior Secretary over non-removal of Dr. Asim's name from ECL. The Supreme Court on Friday issued the Interior Secretary a notice on a contempt of court petition filed against the Interior Ministry by PPP leader Dr. Asim Hussain over non-removal of his name from the no-fly list. Dr. Asim, in the petition filed earlier this week, requested the Apex Court to initiate contempt proceedings against the Ministry of Interior for their failure to remove his name from the exit control list, despite a November 16 order issued to this effect by the Supreme Court. Dr. Asim had requested his name be removed from the ECL so he may be allowed to travel abroad for medical treatment once again. Pope faces diplomatic dilemma in Myanmar visit. Francis visits Myanmar next week, a delegate for the world's most senior Christian to a majority Buddhist country accused by Washington of the ethnic cleansing of Muslim Rohingya people. He will also visit Bangladesh, to where more than 600,000 people have fled from what Amnesty International called crimes against humanity, including murder, rape, torture and forcible displacement, allegations the Myanmar military denies. The trip is so delicate that some of the Pope's advisers have warned him against even saying the word Rohingya, lest he set off a diplomatic incident that could turn the country's military and government against minority Christians. The most tense moments of the November 26-December 2 trip are likely to be private meetings with Army Head Senior General Min Aung Hlaing and separately civilian leader Aung San Suu Kyi. China forges strategic ties with Djibouti after opening base. Chinese President Xi Jinping and Djibouti's visiting leader Omar Ismail Guelleh, whose African nation is hosting China's first overseas military base, agreed on Thursday to elevate their nation's diplomatic relations. The two countries agreed to form a strategic partnership as Guelleh held talks with Xi at the imposing Great Hall of the People in Beijing. China has described the base on the Horn of Africa, which opened in August, as defensive in nature, saying it will provide support for naval escorts. UN peacekeeping, anti-piracy and evacuating Chinese nationals from the region in emergencies. Pakistan sells about 100 aircraft at international market. Minister for Defence Production Rana Tanveer Hussain has said that Pakistan is making progress in defence production. In an interview with the news channel, he said about 100 small aircraft manufactured by Pakistani defence industry have been sold out to other countries so far. He said efforts are being made to bring improvements to the marketing of defence production. Rana Tanveer Hussain said there is rich potential to introduce Pakistan's defence-related products in the other world countries. Pakistani scientist discovers disease caused by interfamily marriage. Scientists at Institute of Biomedical and Genetic Engineering (IBGE) in collaboration with researchers of Europe and Singapore has discovered a new disease in Pakistan that leads to the lifetime paralysis of the patient. The cause of the disease is interfamily marriage. The disease, coined as Siddiqui syndrome, causes deafness in the patient at the age of 6 months and leads to a complete paralysis of the body by the age of 11. This deafness dystonia includes repetitive muscle contractions, their twisting and other abnormal movements. PCB wants government to introduce a corruption law in sports. The Pakistan Cricket Board has requested the government to introduce a law about corruption in sports in order to stop the players from doing any kind of fixing in the game. A PCB official said that the board lays emphasis on removing corruption from cricket. In this regard, PCB has already introduced a strict anti-corruption code and it has a permanent vigilance department in PCB to counter the menace of corruption, he said. He said the board believes that corruption in cricket and other sports can largely be prevented if a law is passed making corruption in sports a crime. Now, weather forecast for next 12 hours. Mainly cold and dry weather is expected in most parts of the country. Foggy conditions are likely over a few plain areas of Punjab and Upper Sindh during evening. And that is the end of the news. For more news and updates, please keep watching Hums Up TV. Take care. Please subscribe to Hums Up TV and hit the notification icon on the screen to get the latest updates of our channel. Thank you for watching Hums Up TV.